his neck for Rubber Man. Shuffle.
Oh, can you dig it, Chris Arps? You've got a frog in your throat or you're sick, one of the two.
I apologize to the audience. I'm not sick, but that didn't...
You know, on your way down here next time, you need to do some vocal exercises to warm up for that high-pitched, can you dig it, that you do there, because I can't do it.
Kind of automatic, but couldn't do it this time. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing all right, man. How are you?
Good. I can't complain.
Good. You know, I've been talking to people about this since yesterday, this information that's come out in the Eric Greitens case, and this is pretty fascinating, folks. The allegation here by the governor's defense attorneys is that Kim Gardner, they paint a picture of a city circuit attorney who is out of control and out of her depth, very quite frankly, reaching the conclusion that she, and I quote here from the document from the 22nd Judicial Court, the circuit attorney has grossly exceeded her statutory authority and violated the law by contractually agreeing that an active criminal defense attorney openly funded by the defendant's political opponent may not only prosecute the defendant but may hire a private prosecutor to aid him in their endeavor. So she hired this Ronald Sullivan guy as a special prosecutor in the Greitens case. He's not even licensed in Missouri. She apparently, their allegation is she didn't have the authority to do that. Then she granted him the authority to bring in other people to work for him based on the salary she was paying him, which would mean Kim Gardner wouldn't even know who these people were. And you know, his defense team, Greitens' defense team, says this isn't legal. They quote the state law that they're violating here. Chris, I see this as the beginning of the end of this Greitens' case.
I have to agree with you on that. You know, the two instances of one hiring an outside investigator who is not even licensed to practice that in Missouri.
Right.
And then you have the outside, you know, $120,000 person that they're paying from Harvard to come in and do the investigation. I've said this before when we were talking about this over the past couple of weeks. It's almost like Kim Gardner was put up by somebody to do this investigation. I don't know if it was Claire McCaskill's campaign to do this in order to embarrass the governor and try to, you know, get the women's vote away from Republicans in November. I don't know. But Kim Gardner is an attorney, and some of these actions that she has taken has making non-attorneys like you and me and others question exactly what she is doing. And every move that she seems to be making towards this in this case just screams partisanship.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. You know, as I read back through this, it's pretty amazing. Without justification or explanation, in an unprecedented maneuver and contrary to multiple state laws, Circuit Attorney Kim Gardner has attempted to appoint Ronald Sullivan to prosecute this case. Among the weird things about that is that Sullivan's not a prosecutor. He's a criminal defense attorney who just so happens to have been funded at one time by George Soros and also apparently worked on a couple of other high-profile cases around the country.
You know, it's almost starting to kind of smell like, hey, I've got a high-profile case. There's some money to be made. So if you're from Michigan and you're a private investigator, come to St. Louis, investigate this. I've got some money for you. If you are a Harvard attorney, you come in from Boston, I've got a little set of money set over here for you. I mean, this reeks of cronyism and reeks of partisanship. I mean, this case, and I don't blame the governor for wanting to have this case judged by the judge instead of by a jury. It, in my opinion, it may prolong the case because I think a jury would probably throw this out in about 2 hours. But a judge, so that he's not looking political, will deliberate for a couple of days to make it look like it was sobering and thoughtful and will unacquit him. But that's pretty much my opinion at this stage.
It's kind of sad. What they point out here, and bear in mind, this is coming from Ed Dowd and Scott Rosenblum and the other folks who are the attorneys, because they're trying to get Sullivan disqualified. They want the judge to disqualify him from participating in this case against the governor. What they point out here, specifically about Kim Gardner, they quote a Missouri Supreme Court decision where they specifically pointed out that the prosecutor is the people's representative and their primary duty is not to convict, but to see that justice is done. And the prosecutor should have no private interest in the prosecution. It just goes on and on. And they even included a copy of her contract with this Ronald Sullivan guy, paying him $12,000 a month to come in and do a special, because she couldn't find anybody locally. She had to hire somebody outside to investigate it, and now she's having to hire somebody outside the city to prosecute it.
And you would think our friend Tony Messenger, with all that ink time he has over at the Post-Dispatch and all that ink and time he's been spending attacking Governor Greitens, that he would look into this. I mean, this just screams investigation.
I don't know what you're talking about. Tony doesn't have a lot of time to write, given the fact that although his job is downtown and he spends most of his time agreeing with the progressive vacuum that is the city of St. Louis, but he also spends a lot of time driving back out to West County where he chooses to live.
Well, you should have plenty of time to write when you're just reporting talking facts that are faxed over to you every morning and then emailed to you. I mean, that makes your job real easy.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Chris Arps. I appreciate that. At Carps, at C-A-R-P-S on Twitter, at Mark Cox 971 on Twitter.
I don't think Tony Messenger's radio dial is fixed in the 97.1. I'm not worried about it at all.
He's welcome to come on here anytime. I'd love to have him on the bottom line or any other time because he's wrong.
Yes, all the time.
314 314-